Nice to wild forward Zach Parise, skating and skills instructor Andy Ness. This guy's a goal scorer. He's been a goal scorer from the time he came in this league. You don't just become a goal scorer overnight. You work at it. What are we working on today?
Well, you know, the first thing, he's the leading Minnesota-born goal scorer that we have in this state.
He's in, he scores! It makes him the number one all-time goal scorer out of the state of Minnesota.
And so that's the one area I wanted to try to, you know, teach kids and some habits that I see that he does that maybe he doesn't even know, or he learned at a very young age. Little things, like in practices, it's practice habits. You know, when Zach goes in to shoot, he always finishes his shot. He finishes towards the net. You see a lot of younger kids, they'll shoot, and then what do? They fan out and they go right back in line, you know? He'll finish his shot, he'll finish towards the net. He even does things like, you know, when the goalie's not playing out the rebound, he'll always finish shooting the puck into the net. It's always ends up in the back of the net, and it's just little habits like that, but it's practice habits lead to game habits, and it's so important to be able to keep working on that, and you'll see him, he'll do it in practice, and it happens in a game.
And for you, Zach, you're not 6'4", all right? You're not a quote-unquote power forward. You've still got to survive in the trenches, which is down low by the net. These drills could certainly magnify how to be successful at that in the game.
But I take a lot of heat because a lot of my goals are probably not even 5 feet out, all of them. You know, they're all around the paint, but goalies are that good now. You have to get around the net. You have to get loose, find rebounds. It's tough to beat them on the first shot. You're always trying to find that second, third shot, finding space, kind of getting lost around the net. And like Andy was saying, I think it starts in practice getting those habits. I probably drive the goalies a little nuts, always putting them in the back of the net, but I think that type of repetition helps.
Let's go through the drills, guys.
So the first one we're going to do, just real simple. All I'm going to do is I'm just going to give him a pass, just like how many times you've seen him score right on the back door. So I'll give him a pass, he'll catch, step out. Now notice he's giving himself a little bit better angle, steps out, right, over the goalie's shoulder. One more. And then we'll finish with one just off the wall here. We're going to do some tight turns. So a tight turn that he's so good at, those hard escapes. And then as he comes and rolls out of that turn, he's going to come in and shoot.
And we saw, let's start with the first one. We saw, again, the key for every player down low is you're not going to have a lot of time, right? You're going to have to catch that puck. It's got to be gone. That comes from repetition.
It is. It's just practicing. It's knowing your blade. It's knowing your stick, where you want it, where you want to catch it, where you want to shoot it from, and being comfortable doing it under pressure and under stress and putting it on that short side where the goalie's just trying to get over.
Second drill is all about creating space. The one weapon you can use against those big defensemen, Zach, is your speed. And that is a drill that young players can mimic and certainly create space for themselves.
Yeah, it's, you know, you try to get the puck out of the corner as quick as possible. You get it. You don't want to get into a shoving match in there. You want to get it. You want to get possession. Try and create a little separation and then get to the net.
You got to go to the net to be successful at any level of hockey. Watch Zach Parise. Create space. Get rid of that puck. You can score goals just like he does for the Minnesota Wild.